Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you Telangana current affairs for 3 months, October, November and December. If you are wondering what about January to October, so before this I uploaded 2 videos in which I covered current affairs from January to September. And for the last 3 months, I will cover this into just one video, which is this video that you are watching. But before this, I request to you, please watch my 2 videos and the link is in the description below. And also in the comments if you want to watch the current affairs from January to September. Also, what I'll do is I will make one video in which I will collate all the 3 videos into one, so that you get all the current affairs of 2017 for Telangana into one place. And this is the new map of Telangana, and you know that earlier there were only 10 districts, now 21 new districts were made, so total it has now 31 districts. StudyIQ has launched a lot of pen drive courses for UPSC and for various exams. We are also trying to bring APPSC and TSPSC pen drive courses. We are trying to find a very good faculty that can keep up with the quality that StudyIQ is known for. And as soon as we launch that, we'll let you know. But just go to our website studyiq.com if you want to know about some of the pen drive courses that we sell that are already available. You can connect with me on Instagram. If you have any question, you can simply shoot me a message on Instagram. That is my ID, Tireless Soul. Or you can follow me on Twitter also. So let's start. I will keep also giving you some extra information that will help you in your current affairs. So Kaleshwaram lift irrigation project has now got environmental clearance. Environment clearance is given by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, and it is headed by Dr. Harshvardhan. He is the Minister for Environment, Forest and Climate Change. He is also the Minister for Science and Technology. He is also the Minister for Earth Sciences, and he is a Lok Sabha MP from New Delhi, Chandni Chowk. Now, there are 2 important projects that are in news, right? So, in Andhra Pradesh, we have Polavaram project, okay? Polavaram. But in Telangana, we have Kaleshwaram project. Now, it's a costly project, okay? It is a very costly project. It will cost 80,499 crore rupees, and it will be completed in next 3 years. Now, Environment Ministry, they have given the approval, but they have said that you need to make sure that the climate is not affected. So you have to take care of the changes in the microclimatic conditions for the same. And government will take up, the work as per the procedure of right to fair compensation and transparency in land acquisition. So a lot of land acquisition needs to be done for this project, and there were some protests also, because there were compensation issues that the farmers, they were saying that the land is acquired but they are not adequately compensated for. So that is why it took some time, and now finally the process can start. Now let me tell you something more about this project that you should know. The Kaleshwaram project, what it will do is there will be a construction of a barrage across river Godavari. Okay, now river Godavari, it takes its origin near Nasik in Maharashtra. Okay, and on the bank of Godavari, you also have Kumbh Mela in Nasik. Kumbh Mela in India is at 4 places. One is Haridwar on the bank of Ganga River. Then we have on Allahabad, where there is a confluence of Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati, there is a Kumbh Mela. Then you have at Ujjain on the bank of the Shipra River, you have Kumbh Mela. And finally, on the bank of Godavari, you have the Kumbh Mela in Nasik. So this project will construct a barrage. It will set up a barrage across river Godavari near Madigadda village in Karimnagar district of Telangana. This, what is the aim? Aim is to divert 180 TMC of water for providing irrigation in more than 7 lakh hectare land covering 7 districts of Adilabad, Karimnagar, Nizamabad, Warangal, Medak, Nalagonda and Rangareddy district. So if they ask in exam, how many districts will be benefited? The answer is 7 districts will be benefited by the Kaleshwaram project. And you should know which are the districts. Adilabad, Karimnagar, Nizamabad, Warangal, Medak, Nalagonda and Rangareddy. And therefore, it will benefit more than 7 lakh hectare lands. Very, very big project. So total land that is required is 32,000 hectare, right? And out of that, 2,866 hectare is the forest land. And the total submergence area is estimated to be about 13,706 hectare. Submergence area is the area that is under water, okay, and that is why this area is not suitable for farming or any other wildlife or anything like that, because it is submerged under water. And there are more barrages planned. Now, what is a barrage? See, there is a river, right? So you put a barrage to divert some of the water. So if you put a barrage here, the river is flowing like this, okay, in this direction, you put a barrage, then the water will be diverted. So barrages are put to divert the water. For example, you have the Farakka barrage, which is the largest barrage in India, in Farakka in West Bengal, which diverts water of River Ganga, okay, into Hugli River. So similarly, two more barrages will be put. One is at Madigadda and second is at Shiripada Yalampalli, okay. And this project will also have a canal system of about 1832 kilometer. And this project lies in the interstate boundary with submergence of 302 hectare in Maharashtra. So this project requires about 4,227 megawatt of power to be supplied by TG Genco company. And public hearing for the project will be conducted in 15 districts of the state and one district in Maharashtra that will be affected by the Kaleshwaram project. And remember, Polavaram project is in Andhra. Now, remember one more thing, that for Andhra, I also made two current affairs covering current affairs from January to July, January to August. And for the last 3 months, I will also make for Andhra. But if you want to check out Andhra current affairs, that can also be useful for Telangana exam. That two videos are already available, and that also in the description, you will find the link. Now, central government has approved agreement with UNESCO. Now, what will UNESCO do? UNESCO will establish ITCOO in Hyderabad, the capital of Telangana. Now, what is UNESCO? It is United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, and it is headquartered in Paris. Paris is the capital of France, and it is the headquarter of UNESCO also and OECD also, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development. And UNESCO's Director General, also called UNESCO's Chief, is Audrey Azoulay. Remember her name. A-U-D-R-E-Y, Audrey Azoulay. She is the new Director General of UNESCO. UNESCO also lists World Heritage Sites. There are 36 World Heritage Sites in India. Earlier, there were 35, but 36 World Heritage Site is Ahmedabad City. So, Pradhan Mantri Modi, he approved the establishment of an International Training Center for Operational Oceanography as a Category 2 Center of UNESCO in Hyderabad. What is the purpose of this agreement? The training center will be built that will develop our capacity for the countries on the Indian Ocean rim. So, Indian Ocean is said to be the next powerhouse, you know, in very important for geopolitical considerations. And this operational oceanography is an activity of conducting systematic oceanographic studies so that it can help our fishermen, it can help in disaster management, it can help in shipping, ports and navy and coast guard and like that. Now, this will also provide an opportunity for India to emerge as a leading country in the Indian Ocean. Also, in Indian Ocean, we also conduct various exercises like Malabar exercise that we do with America and with Japan. It's a trilateral exercise. So, the center could contribute to achieving Sustainable Development Goal 14, that is related to building marine scientific research capacity in geographical area of central responsibility, which will also fulfill the commitment of small island developing state. Now, there are 17 Sustainable Development Goals, remember that. And the 17 Sustainable Development Goal we have to achieve by the year 2030. So, the center is currently operational with a state-of-the-art facility available at Indian Ocean for Ocean Information Services, that is INCOIS Hyderabad. And a lot of scientists will actually sit here. World Telugu Conference 2017 took place in Hyderabad on 15th of December. World Telugu Conference, and Vice President of India, he is the 13th Vice President of India, Venkaiah Naidu, he inaugurated it in the presence of Governor of Telangana, Mr. ESL Narasimha. Remember that ESL Narasimha is not only the Governor of Telangana, he is also the Governor of Andhra Pradesh. And also, Governor of Maharashtra, Vidyasagar Rao, was also present. And Chief Minister of Telangana, Mr. Chandrasekhar Rao, was also present. So this took place on 15th of December. Now let me tell you one more thing. Telugu is also the language of Andhra Pradesh. And recently, the government of Telangana, they have declared Urdu language as the second official language of Telangana. Now, you know about the Global Entrepreneurship Summit. This took place in Hyderabad in Telangana. And Ivanka Trump, see, Ivanka Trump is daughter of Donald Trump. Donald Trump is the president of India and he is from Republican Party. Wife of Donald Trump is Melania Trump. So don't confuse Melania with Ivanka. Ivanka is daughter, Melania is wife. So she was the guest, and PM Modi and Ivanka Trump, they both inaugurated the Global Entrepreneurship Summit in Hyderabad. Now there is a robot which is called Mitra. Mitra basically means your friend. Mitra, it is a made in India robot. It was developed by a Bengaluru based inventor. So it greeted both the leaders with Namaste. So remember, the name Mitra is the name of the robot that was inaugurated here. And Mitra had a partner as another bot that was deployed. The bot was designed by Balaji Vishwanathan and his 14 member team. So this was the 8th edition of the Global Entrepreneurship Summit, and this basically celebrates entrepreneurship and provides opportunities. World's first IT campus for persons with disability. Disability, we these days we don't say disabled person, we say differently abled, because there is everything these people can do. So world's first IT campus, information technology campus for the people with disability, will come up in Hyderabad. This has been decided by the government, and for that they have entered into an agreement with a company called Vindhya E Info Media Private Limited. This company will help the government in setting up of an IT campus for people with disability in Hyderabad. This will be spread over 10 acres and it will be near the Rajiv Gandhi International Airport. Remember that India's Information Technology Minister is Ravi Shankar Prasad. He is also the Law Minister of India. Now, what will be there in this center? It will have training, residential facility also. It is expected to create job for 2000 people in the next 5 years. And Vindhya E Infomedia is one of the pioneers in this thing. And this is the company that will make this center. As I told you, Urdu becomes second official language in Telangana after Telugu. So this has been decided. Opposition was crying foul that this has been done to gain the vote of minorities. But now all the government offices, they will use Urdu also. So this is the notification. And every office in Telangana will have a Urdu speaking officer also. And all the competitive exam in state will also be conducted in Urdu. So what does the Constitution of India say about the official language? Article 345 of the Indian Constitution, it speaks about the official language of the state. According to Article 345, see, there are 22 official languages in Indian Constitution. Okay, 22. And that's all you need to know about the language. Can you tell me, can you write down in comments which schedule of the Indian Constitution mentions about all the languages? Let's see who answers this question. Telangana topped the state-wise ease of doing business ranking in 2017. So this was the Business Reform Action Plan, BRAP. This was the assessment done. And the final ranking will be released in January 2018. Telangana had an implementation score of 61.83%. Second was Haryana. Third was Odisha, fourth Chhattisgarh, five West Bengal. These are the top five. So in ease of doing business, we are doing really well. This is a ranking given by the World Bank. And these rankings are dynamic. They keep on changing. But the year-end ranking, the final ranking, will be released in January 2018. But at one point of time, Telangana was definitely number one, followed by Haryana. And if you remember last year, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh were the top two. So the last date was around October 31st to November 7. This was the date when the Commerce Ministry expected all the states to furnish the data, and on the basis of which they will decide which state is number one. And last year, as I said, Telangana was the joint topper with Andhra Pradesh. So this year, Andhra Pradesh is a little low. And India was last year 130 in ease of doing business. This year, India is ranked 100th out of 190 countries. So India showed a jump of 30 places. You have to remember that also. Now, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, they may soon be foot and mouth disease free. Now, let me tell you something interesting. See, government of India said that we will become free of Kala Azar disease. This is a disease called Kala Azar. We will become free by 31st of December 2017. But we have not been able to achieve this target. That is what Arun Jaitley, the honorary Minister of Finance, declared right now. Okay, just 3 or 4 days back. Now, India has become free from two diseases recently. One is the cattle disease called Rinderpest. India has eliminated Rinderpest disease. And India has also eliminated trachoma. It is a disease of the eye. It was announced by our health minister. Our health minister is JP Nadda. He is from Himachal Pradesh. Then our health secretary is Preeti Sudan. Right. And our minister of state for health is Anupriya Patel. So remember that. And India has also set up three important targets. We want to eliminate HIV/AIDS by 2030. Remember that. We want to eliminate HIV/AIDS by 2030. We want to eliminate malaria by 2027. In fact, World Health Organization target to eliminate malaria from the world is 2030. But India's target is 2027. So India wants to achieve it even before World Health Organization. And India wants to eliminate tuberculosis by 2025. Tuberculosis is caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis. It is a bacterial disease. 2025, India will eliminate tuberculosis. Now, let's see whether we are able to achieve this target or not. So, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh may very soon be foot and mouth disease free. Foot and mouth disease is caused in cattle. Okay. So, it is caused in cattle. And just remember the name, foot and mouth disease. It is very contagious disease. It is caused by a virus. And it is found in animals like cattle, pigs, sheep and goats. So the infection is there. There are ulcers and blisters on the body. And so if there is no cure for this disease, then it spreads in various animals. Both the states, Andhra and Telangana, they have completed 22 rounds of the disease control program biannually, which means twice in every year. Over 11 years. And also Telangana will hold a massive vaccine campaign to cover 100% cattle in the next round that starts 29 December 2017 till 13th of January 2018. According to the ICAR directorate, only 5 states in India are there which do not have any evidence of foot and mouth disease. So yeah, just remember the name. Now, the government wants to establish, the government of Telangana, it wants to establish Clean Authority of Telangana. It is an apex body, which means it is a supreme body that will make sure that there is good cleanliness, there is wastewater management, there is dumping management, that is, there is human waste management that therefore do not cause any harm to the people. So all sorts of solid waste management, liquid waste management, wastewater management will be done by this Clean Authority of Telangana. And this kind of thing is already present in Japan. Remember that. So they want to emulate Japan in establishing a clean authority for Telangana. Telangana is ready to introduce intrastate electronic way bills. So it was initially contemplated to introduce the intrastate electronic way bill by the end of financial year. But the central government extended the deadline to June 1, asking the state to put in the necessary system to enforce the decision. So what exactly is this? This proposal will make it mandatory for the transporters and suppliers to generate electronic way bills for goods manufactured within the state and which are moved to other state. This proposal is because the recent intensive checks were conducted by the Commercial Tax Department. They found that almost 10% of the vehicles that were carrying the freight, that were carrying the goods and goods, they were found to have not be having required documents. And that is why there is a lot of black money that is generated. That is why electronic way bills will be made mandatory. Now Telangana has started free 24-hour power supply to farmer. Okay. This will supply round the clock 24/7 power supply to 23 lakh farmers free of cost. Remember that. And this scheme, the Transmission Corporation of Telangana Limited Chairman and Managing Director is Mr. D. Prabhakar Rao and Southern DISCOM MD Mr. Raghurama Reddy. They formally launched the scheme at Pothaipalli village of Samirpet Mandal in Medchal Malkajgiri district. So where was this scheme launched from? You should know. It was launched from this village called Pothaipalli village in Samirpet Mandal in Medchal Malkajgiri district. Okay, at midnight. Telangana Chief Minister Chandrasekhar Rao has described, you know, it as a New Year gift for the farmers of Telangana. Telangana is the only state in India which is supplying power to farmers free of cost. The free power supply will be available for 23 lakh agriculture pump set. And according to Prabhakar Rao, the demand from the agriculture sector in January will be around 9500 megawatt, and it might go up to 11,000 megawatt by March. All the police station in Telangana, they will have social media account. Okay, they will have social media account. All the police stations will have a Facebook page and Twitter handle so that they can communicate with the people. And you know that the Director General of Police of Telangana, Mr. Mahender Reddy, he has declared 2018 as the year of technology and citizen friendly initiatives for the Telangana police. Year 2018 has been declared as the year of technology and citizen friendly initiatives. As per the annual plan 2018, the community CCTV project, closed circuit television camera CCTV project, will be extended to all the urban center, and social media lab will also be set up in all the districts of Telangana, that is all the 31 districts of Telangana. And also, the safety and security of the women will continue to be top priority, and the she teams for women's safety will be equipped with modern evidence. So in Telangana, you have the she teams for the women's safety. Japanese consulate general to provide aid for safe drinking water in Telangana. See, two villages will soon get access to safe drinking water with Japan's grant assistance. And the contract was signed in Chennai to provide financial assistance to set up two water purification plant. This project was signed by Seiji Baba, he is the Consul General of Japan, Chennai, and Mr. Pushya Mitra Sharma, he is the Managing Trustee, Safe Water Network India, which is a NGO. Now, you should know the two villages that are in question here. Both the villages are in Medak district in Telangana. One is called Podichan Palle and the second is called Shan Karam Pat villages. One is called Podichan Palle and the second is Shan Karam Pat village. These are the two villages that will have water purification system by Japan, and 31 lakh rupees is provided as a help or the grant by the Japan, Consulate General of Japan, which is in Chennai. So remember that this is very important, and remember the name of the two villages also. Telangana has signed an agreement with a company called Ativo. Okay, it is a part of SREI group, and it will manufacture or it will set up a infra park. It will set up a infra park where the manufacturing of infrastructure equipment will be done. And this, this park will be set up in the National Investment and Manufacturing Zone, NIMZ, which is coming up near Zahirabad town in Telangana. This park, infra park, will be set up at Zahirabad, near Zahirabad. And it will come up over 500 acres of land, and it will have potential to generate direct and indirect employment for 10,000 persons over the next 10 years. Annual conference was conducted to celebrate Telugu language. So Chandrasekhar Rao CM announced an annual festival henceforth to celebrate Telugu language in the context of Telangana culture. So each year during December, a 2-day Telangana Telugu conference, which will be called Telangana Telugu Maha Sabhalu, it will be organized on a grand scale. So there was also recently 5th World Telugu Conference that was conducted. Okay, so there will be an annual conference and there will be World Telugu Conference also. So 5th World Telugu Conference was recently conducted. There he announced that now from now on, every December we will have 2-day Telangana Telugu Maha Sabhalu Fest. Now, Telangana government has also made Telugu learning compulsory from class 1 to intermediate. 31 lakh sheep, they have been tagged in Telangana. Telangana government has successfully ear tagged and photographed all the 31.77 lakh sheep that have been procured from the neighboring states under the special package for sheep development for the sheep and goat farmers. The Telangana State Sheep and Goat Development Cooperative Finance Limited has managed to achieve this distinction in less than 8 months after the government decided to accord top priority to improve the economic standard of the shepherd community by providing financial assistance to the sheep and goat rearers to start each unit comprising 20 ewes and 1 ram at a cost of 1.25 lakh rupees. I repeat once more, 31 lakh sheep in Telangana, they have been ear tagged, and these were the sheep that were bought from the other states. So this will improve the economic standard, the financial level of the shepherds of Telangana. So remember that Telangana government has provided financial assistance to the sheep and goat rearers to start each unit, which comprises 20 ewes and one ram at a cost of 1.25 lakh rupees. And each ear tag on the sheep has an 11-digit identification number. 11-digit identification number. To make it foolproof, a picture of sheep is taken and uploaded on the official portal of the department also. The scheme is being implemented with the funds to the tune of 5,000 crore rupees that has been provided by National Cooperative Development Corporation, New Delhi. And the government is also giving 75% subsidy to the beneficiaries, while each member of the primary sheep breeders cooperative society has to pay 25% of the cost of each unit. Now remember, cost of each lamb is around 4,000 rupees and each beneficiary is expected to get around 32,000 per unit for the 8 lambs. And a sum of 484 crore rupees will accrue to the beneficiaries with the birth of the lambs. Consumer protection councils will be formed in Telangana in all the districts of the state. Telangana government will take all the steps to strengthen consumer organizations and set up district consumer protection council in all the 31 districts soon. And the new amended Consumer Protection Act of 1986 is expected to be passed in the current session of the parliament. Telangana will build Asia's largest pump house next year. Irrigation Department of Telangana has decided that they will conduct the dry run. This is a 140 megawatt capacity pump and it is first of the 7 pumps being installed at Ramadugu Reservoir, which is 180 kilometers away from Hyderabad. And the discharge capacity of the single electric pump is so huge that it can fill the Hussain Sagar Lake in Hyderabad in just a couple of days. The Ramadugu point is a part of the Kaleshwaram irrigation project. The pump house of Ramadugu, it is said to be the largest of its kind in Asia and it can discharge 21 cusecs of water, when all the 7 pumps are switched on. Total, there will be 7 pumps. And Ramadugu pump house is just one of the 4 stages of this Kaleshwaram project. So, remember just this. Telangana IT Minister, Mr. K.T. Rama Rao, he is son of Chandrasekhar Rao, CM. He will attend Davos Summit. He will attend the annual meeting of the World Economic Forum. Now, this will also be attended by Narendra Modi. And let me tell you something interesting, that the last Prime Minister who attended a meeting of the World Economic Forum was actually Devegowda in 1997. So, it is after 21 years that any Indian Prime Minister is attending a World Economic Forum Summit. World Economic Forum is headquartered in Switzerland. And this will be held in January 2018 at Davos in Switzerland. Survey on agrarian distress in Telangana villages has been conducted. It was conducted by Telangana Joint Action Committee, which is an apolitical body. It will conduct this in all the 119 assembly constituency in Telangana to study why the farmers are committing suicides, why there is a lack of trust in the farmers. So, the yield of farmer, the harvest is decreasing. So, 49% of the state's total cultivable area, there was sowing of the seeds, which is unprecedented, which is the highest. But still, the crop harvest was less because of rainfall and various other factor. Telangana has also joined NEET. So, this is National Eligibility Entrance Test for the medical student. And the center had exempted Andhra Pradesh from Rule 371 for the next academic year in this regard, but Telangana will be a part of this. So, undivided Andhra Pradesh and Jammu Kashmir, they were exempted from national pool because of the implementation of Article 371D since 1975, which allows for special conditions in these states. However, the Telangana government will now have to give 15% of MBBS seats and 50% of postgraduate medical seat to the national pool in NET. Remember this, 15% of the MBBS seats in Telangana and 50% of PG medical seat will be part of NEET. Telangana villages, the Telangana village, which is Tellapur, it is at Ramachandrapuram Mandal in Sangareddy district. It has got the first rank in the country. So as many as 33 Gram Panchayat of Andhra Pradesh, they stood among the top 83 best Gram Panchayat in the country as per the Mission Antyodaya ranking of Gram Panchayat given by the central government. And 7 villages of the state, they earned place in the top 100 along with 1 village from each state of Telangana, Karnataka and Kerala in the list. And the number 1 village in the country is Tellapur. It is in Ramachandrapuram Mandal in Sangareddy district. Now, Parapatala village in the Kalikiri Mandal of Chittur district, it is ranked 2nd. and Chaddikala village in Chaddikala Mandal in Vishakhapatnam in Andhra is third. If you remember, Vishakhapatnam was the third cleanest city of India in the cleanliness survey or Swachh Sarvekshan 2017. And Vishakhapatnam railway station was the cleanest railway station of India in the busy railway station category A1. Similarly, Kujjurullu village in Kujjurullu Mandal in East Godavari and Unguturu of Krishna district, Aguva Tuvanampalle of Chittur district, they were ranked 4 with 88 score. Indupalli village in Unguturu Mandal of Krishna district got 5th rank and Mahal village in Kalikiri Mandal of Chittur got 6th rank. Of the total 83 Gram Panchayat, 33 are from Andhra, 21 from Tamil Nadu, 6 from Kerala, 5 from Maharashtra and 4 from Telangana. Out of the top 83 Gram Panchayat, 4 are from Telangana. And number 1 is of course Telangana. Now Telangana government has asked Israel country to audit Telangana cyber policy. See, Israel is one of the global leaders in cyber. Israel and Russia, there is no match in their cyber capacity. So Israel will help Telangana, and Israel's National Information Security Agency's success in creating a cyber security network is very impressive. That is why the government of Telangana is asking for help from Israel. Now there is a scheme which is called, you spot a beggar in Hyderabad, you inform and you get 500 rupees reward. So Telangana, you know, government wants to make Hyderabad beggar free, and this is the first time that any city in India wants to become beggar free. So Telangana prison department has announced 500 rupees to anyone who spot a beggar in the city and inform it to the official. Then what will the prison department do? They will lift the beggar from the street and they will put them in a shelter home which is called Anand Ashram, which is an enclosure besides the Chanchala Guda Central Prison in the outskirts of Hyderabad. Chanchala Guda Central Prison, there is an Anand Ashram where they will be taken. These are the number. So if you want to earn some money, you spot beggars. Telangana has also planned something which is Urdu conference. So recently, 5th World Telugu Conference was conducted in Telangana. Now they are also finalizing that they want to conduct Urdu conference also, because they recently have made a second language Urdu. And they have chosen Golconda Fort as the venue for the Urdu conference. In Telangana, 12,500 habitations will get piped water in 2018. This is called Mission Bhagirath. Mission Bhagirath is the flagship, the main scheme of the Telangana Rashtriya Samiti government. This is to provide piped water to all the household in the state through taps. And so far, 1.69 lakh kilometer of pipelines have been put, and together they are drawing 42.67 TMC of water from the Krishna and Godavari river for the project. This project has made a lot of progress, and Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi, PM, he had formally launched Mission Bhagirath from Gajwel in Medak district in August 2016. 90% of the work has been completed in 2017, only 10% of the work is remaining in 2018. So 12,500 habitations will get piped water, and this is called Mission Bhagirath. Now let me tell you one more mission by Kakatiya, by government, which is called Kakatiya, Mission Kakatiya. It is to fill all the empty reservoirs once again. That is called Mission Kakatiya. That is also going in Telangana. So half of the total 25,000 habitations will get Mission Bhagirath piped water by January 2000. This is 18 actually. And the deadline, part 2 deadline of June 2018 has been fixed. So what is the deadline of Mission Bhagirath? June 2018. And it is a project which is costing 45,000 crore rupees. It is the first initiative of its kind in India, where the water will be given through taps, through pipes. And Gujarat is the first in the country to launch a water grid, but it covers only 65% of the population in the drought prone area, with a pipeline network of 1.2 lakh kilometer. And TS water grid, the Telangana state water grid, covers the state with a pipeline network of 1.69 lakh kilometer. Also remember that this Mission Bhagirath will also provide internet also. So optic fiber cable are also being let down along with Mission Bhagirath pipeline. So Mission Bhagirath pipeline, it will provide water, but side by side optic fiber cable are also being let down, so that broadband facility, internet can also be provided by end of 2018. That is the target. And the project target is 5 liter of water per minute per household. 5 liter of water per minute per household. And it will provide 100 liter per person per day to every house in villages, and 135 liters per person per day in municipality, and 150 liter per person per day in big cities. Telangana has opposed inclusion of petrol and real estate in the GST, Goods and Services Tax, which is 122nd Amendment Bill and 101st Amendment Act. So, the Finance Minister of Telangana, Mr. Aitala Rajender, he said that petrol and real estate should not be included in the GST. That was his view. Telangana debt burden likely to be more than 10% this fiscal, the fiscal deficit. Okay. Now, let me tell you something more, that the fiscal deficit, according to the fiscal regulation and budget management, it should not be more than 3% of the state GDP. And according to 14th Finance Commission, which is right now the Finance Commission headed by Y.V. Reddy, who is the ex-governor of Reserve Bank of India, 3% of state GDP fiscal deficit should not be more than that. If it is more than that, then your financial management in the state is not good. So the interest burden for this fiscal, that is ending on 31st March 2018, it started on 1st April 2017, is projected to touch 11,500 crore rupees, which is more than 10% of the projected revenue collection of 79,000 crore rupees. And despite being a revenue surplus state, the government will lose more and more because of the increased burden of interest. Now, the central government allows only up to 3% of the state GDP fiscal deficit, as I told you. But for revenue surplus state, it allows up to 3.5%. So only Gujarat and Telangana, they qualify for this because these are the only two revenue surplus states in the country. Now, Tiger census will be conducted in Telangana from January 22 to January 29, 2018. And this is the fourth Tiger census since 2006. It will be the first since the bifurcation of the state. So we'll see what is the number of tiger, although the forest department claimed that there is a 6% annual growth in tigers. Telangana district, they registered huge tourist inflow in 2015 and 2016. At least four among the 10 districts that were there earlier, they received higher tourist footfall than the state capital Hyderabad and the neighboring Rangareddy district during the last couple of years. This information was provided in the statistical yearbook that was released recently. So according to the yearbook, 1.57 crore tourists visited Warangal during 2016, followed by Karimnagar, 1.19 crore. And the twin cities, and Rangareddy was placed third with an inflow of 1.09 crore visitors, followed by Mehboob Nagar at fourth position with 90.76 lakh. So which place in Telangana receives maximum tourists? The answer is Warangal. 1.57 crore tourists came in 2016. Second is Karimnagar. Now let's talk about foreign tourists. The state capital Hyderabad received maximum foreign tourists, total 1.63 lakh out of the 1.66 lakh who visited the state. So if foreigners are coming, they are only coming in Hyderabad because 1.66 lakh foreign tourists came, and out of that 1.63, almost 100%, they came to Hyderabad. But domestic tourists, number one is Warangal, number two is Karimnagar. Medha Servo plans rupees 800 crore rail and metro coach factory in Telangana. So this is a Hyderabad based company called Medha Servo Drives, and it is part of the 1000 crore Medha group. It wants to have 800 crore rupees rail and metro coach factory in Telangana. This will be built at Kondakal near Hyderabad in Telangana. Investment will be 800 crore rupees. Telangana has started something known as V-Hub. If you remember, earlier, it had something known as T-Hub. That was the Telangana Hub. That was for entrepreneurship. Now, it has something called a V-Hub. So, this V-Hub is for women only. Okay. So, this is called V-Hub. And the budget is 15 crore rupees. That is the amount that is kept separately only for V-Hub. That is the fund. 15 crore rupees. So, Niti Aayog bagged project this is. And these funds, 15 crore, will be made under the Atal Innovation Mission. Atal Innovation Mission. So under the Atal Innovation Mission, named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee, ex-Prime Minister of India, the focus would be on encouraging and setting up of tinkering labs in schools for girls, emphasizing the importance being laid on increasing, promoting entrepreneurship in the country. The state has also decided to create 15 crore rupees fund for women startups, where women entrepreneurs will be extended financial support ranging from 25 lakh rupees to 1 crore. In V-Hub, women will get 25 lakh rupees to 1 crore of rupees for their business, starting their businesses. It is only for women, and T-Hub was also set up earlier on. But remember, V-Hub is mainly for innovation, for entrepreneurship and innovation. Telangana will waive off the power dues for scheduled tribe community. This has been decided by the government. There were 70 crore rupees of dues, but now government has decided that they will waive off this dues. So, and remember one more thing, that the power connection is provided to each and every ST house for only 125 rupees per connection. Only 125 rupees per connection. And the electricity department will charge any tariff if the power consumption is below 50 unit. It will not charge any tariff if the power consumption is below 50 unit. Telangana to set up IT corridor and industrial estate for Muslims. So it was decided to construct Hyderabad International Islamic Cultural Convention Center. This will be built at Kokapet, and this will be international standard. Also, Chandrasekhar Rao has said there is 10% quota for the minorities. And you know, so 10% quota in the state's double bedroom housing scheme for economically weaker section. This was also recently announced. And entrance test must be held in Urdu also, along with English and Telugu. So the Telangana government will set up exclusive industrial estate and information technology corridor for Muslims. And Hyderabad International Islamic Cultural Convention Center will be built at Kokapet. Also, with regard to the old city area, Chandrasekhar Rao said that the 426-year-old Char Minar, which is the face of Hyderabad, should be developed on the lines of the Golden Temple in Amritsar. He wants to develop it, and he also wants to develop a 42-kilometer riverfront along the Musi River, on the bank of which Hyderabad is there. Just like we have Sabarmati riverfront in Gujarat, 42-kilometer riverfront should be developed on Musi River, and remember that. Telangana government will use blockchain technology for securing the land record. Blockchain technology is used by Bitcoin and all these cryptocurrencies. So more than 10,000 revenue villages, the Telangana state government will maintain the agricultural land records digitally using the blockchain technology. The IT department will prepare a database which will utilize geographical information system to map the properties of landowners in its record. And this is being done as about 20% of the land record in villages across the state were found to be erroneous. So now there will be more transparency, and there will be more easily accessibility of the records. Now also remember that the state Telangana government is verifying and updating land records before starting the input subsidy scheme. Under the input subsidy scheme, 4,000 rupees is given to the farmers in both the Rabi and Kharif season, 4,000 rupees per acre to buy fertilizer, etc. Patanjali, which was recently voted as the most trusted company in India. Patanjali is a company owned by Baba Ramdev and Acharya Balakrishna. Patanjali has signed a memorandum of understanding with Telangana for food park. The Telangana Industrial Infrastructure Corporation and Patanjali, they have signed a memorandum of understanding to develop a food park in Telangana. So they will invest 10,000 crore rupees in Telangana for making this food park. And the food park will have processing of edible oil, fruit, pulp and spices. Bin Zayed Group, they have offered investment of $2 billion in Telangana. This is a Dubai-based company called Bin Zayed Group. So they have already signed a memorandum of understanding, and they will invest in animation and gaming tower, road development, water grid, fiber grid, etc. Telangana has, second rank in the rogues gallery, and Andhra Pradesh is third. What does it mean? So Telangana has left Andhra Pradesh behind in the number of cheating cases that were registered in 2016. National Crime Record Bureau says that Telangana stands at second position in the country. The number of cheating cases were 8,394 in 2016. First position was given by backed by Maharashtra, and then second is Telangana, and the third is Andhra Pradesh. Telangana government has cleared Vijaya Dairy capacity expansion. The capacity of the Vijaya Dairy will be increased. Right now the capacity is 4.5 lakh liter. It will be increased to 8 lakh liter. And for that, 170 crore rupees will be spent. Also, 100 acre land will be acquired at Shamirpet for expansion of the dairy. This was announced by the Minister for Animal Husbandry, Talasani Srinivas Yadav. And also remember that the Minister for Marketing and Irrigation is T. Harish Rao. He said that the government will expand ENAM, that is National Agriculture Market Network, and they will add 14 markets in the state. The state right now, ENAM has 44 markets, which constitute about 10% of the total network of 455 markets in the country. And also remember that cotton has not been included in the ENAM due to the computer issues. It will be added soon. Telangana will form 40 new municipalities soon. This was announced by the Municipal Administration and Urban Development Minister K.T. Rama Rao. So remember that the government has been told to identify the major gram panchayat which have population of more than 10,000. Also, officials, they have been informed or ordered to merge those villages which are falling within the radius of 3 to 5 km under the limit of municipality. Telangana has made a new plan for a new secretariat complex. This new secretariat complex will be developed on the Bison Polo Ground, which is currently a defense property. So according to the Road and Building Ministry, the secretariat complex will have an investment of 300 crore rupees. It will be a three-story building and as it comes in the flight tunnel of the old Begumpet Airport, where there is a restriction of the construction height. The state would get the 38-acre site from the Defense Authority and in turn with about 600 acres to the center to be handed over to the Defense Authority. Telangana State Council to form 3 working panel and 5 incubator very soon. The Telangana State Council of Higher Education will form 3 working panel and 5 incubator. These committees will have academician, industry expert and other stakeholder involved as member. So the target is by 2030 they want to have more job creators. And the incubation center will be made at Osmania University, Kakatiya University, Jawaharlal Nehru Technological University, Hyderabad, Jawaharlal Nehru Architecture and Fine Arts University and Rajiv Gandhi University of Knowledge Technology in Basar. So just remember this. Telangana CM, he let down the foundation of Kakatiya Mega Textile Park in Warangal district. This is in 2,000-acre campus between Shampet and Chintapalli village, and already out of 2,000-acre, 1,200-acre has already been acquired by the government. This is the biggest park, textile park in the country, and this will generate 50,000 jobs. Kakatiya Mega Textile Park in Warangal district. The problem with Telangana was there is a lot of cotton in Telangana. In fact, it was one of the top 3 cotton producing states in the country in 2015-16. But the cotton spinning facilities are very less. So only 20% of the spinning capacity is in Telangana. Most of the other went to Andhra Pradesh when the bifurcation took place. And that is why the state government wants that there should be more spinning mills in the state where cotton can be utilized. Now, Telangana government will send 1,000 officials on Israel junket. So these 1,000 officials will travel to Israel to study farming techniques, because Israel is one of the champions of drip irrigation, where drop by drop water is given to the field, which saves a lot of water. So 1,000 agriculture officers will be sent to Israel in a batch of 100 each to study farming techniques, and that can be applied to Telangana. Christmas gift scheme launched by Chandrasekhar Rao in Telangana for poor people. What is Christmas gift scheme? See, Christmas gift scheme is Telangana government will distribute gift hamper to the poor people. They distributed on the 14th December, and they also organized dinner on 18th December, and for that 15 crore rupees were spent. So this scheme is launched to provide Christmas gift, which include clothes and dinner to the weaker sections of the Telangana state. And under this scheme, the state will ensure that the distributed clothes are of high quality. So as per the collected data, there are around 1 lakh Christians in Hyderabad and Secunderabad city and 1 lakh in rest of the state. So this scheme will benefit around 2 lakh Christians in the weaker sections of the society. So there are Mi Seva health card applications form under employee health scheme in Telangana, Mi Seva health card. The objective of this card is to provide cashless treatment to the state government employees, including the state government pensioners also. And the services of Mi Seva health card will be provided through a network of hospitals of Arogya Shri Healthcare Trust. Under the health card scheme, the government will provide a card or the card number in case the card is not available. The state government will collect a nominal fee of 120 rupees from gazette officers, while rupees 90 from the non-gazette officers. And under this scheme, the state government is providing cashless medical facility to all the employees who are 40 years or more. And the beneficiary will get the healthcare card within 6 months after completing the document facility. And if husband and wife both are working in government job, then both are eligible to apply for health card. So the state government will provide cashless medical facility to all the employees who are 40 years or above or more. And under this employee health scheme, all the government employees and their dependent family member will get 2 lakh rupees for treatment. They can avail 2 lakh rupees per treatment. However, there would be no limit to the number of treatments. But for one person, you can get maximum of 2 lakh rupees. But there is no limit on the number of people. For example, if a person has 10 children, all 10 are covered, but on one children, he can spend maximum of 2 lakh rupees. Rupees 15 crore for handloom weavers loan waiver scheme in Telangana. So the government of Telangana has launched handloom weaver loan waiver scheme. What is this scheme? Loan waiver of up to 1 lakh rupees will be given to the weavers, weaver community. This will benefit more than 2000 weavers in the state. And the handloom weavers loan scheme will cover the loans taken by the weaver from any nationalized bank or district cooperative central bank. If a weaver has taken a loan from a private bank, that will not be covered. He will not get 1 lakh rupees then. You know, the waive off is only if he has taken loan between 1st June 2014 to 31st March 2017 from a nationalized bank or a district cooperative bank. Telangana government has offered subsidy to farmer for buying buffalo. So they want to start a milk revolution. Sheer Viplavam. That in Telugu, Sheer Viplavam means milk revolution. And according to the notification, government will provide 50% subsidy to the farmer from general category. And SCST community farmer will get 75% subsidy. If you are buying buffalo, you from SCST community, you have to pay only 25% because 75% is the subsidy. And if you are from general category, you will get 50% for buying a buffalo. Mahendra Reddy, he is the new DGP of Telangana. Senior IPS officer Mahendra Reddy, and he is the new Director General of Police of Telangana. Now, Dangerous Activities Act, it has been extended in Telangana. The Telangana Legislative Assembly passed 3 bills to amend the existing act, including the Prevention of Dangerous Activities Act. So what has been done now? Now, Telangana Prevention of Dangerous Activities of Bootlegger, Dacoy, Drug Offender, Gunda, Immoral Traffic Offender, Land Grabbers Act of 1986 has been amended. In the amendment, the government has included spurious seed offender, insecticide offender, fertilizer offender, food adulteration offender. So lot of different types of criminals which are coming up, they have been included in this act. So this was the video. But if you have seen the video nicely, then give the answer of these 6 questions. Okay, if you are able to answer this 6 question, then you have seen this video nicely. First question is, how much subsidy will be given to a person from SCST community if he decides to buy a buffalo in Telangana? Okay, if you want to buy a buffalo and you are from SCST, how much subsidy will be given by the Telangana state government to you? That is question number 1. Second question is, from which district was 24-hour free power supply scheme to farmer launched? You know that Telangana government is providing free power supply to farmer. From which district this scheme was launched? That is question number 2. Okay. Then Japan is making 2 villages, safe drinking water enabled. They are putting pump in this. Which 2 villages and which district are these 2 villages are there? Okay. Fourth question. Which city of Telangana received maximum domestic tourist, not international, domestic tourist in 2016? Question number 4. Question 5. What is Mission Bhagirath? What is Mission Bhagirath and from which place it was launched? And the last question is, there are 31 lakh sheep in Telangana that are ear tagged. Now, how many digit number is used? The number that is used to ear tag sheep, it has how many digits? Okay. So these are the 6 questions. Let's see how many you are able to answer. Okay. And with that, goodbye, good luck. But also remember that we have some pen drive courses. In case you want to check it out, go to our website studyiq.com. Thank you so much.